What's good, gamers? Welcome back to the channel. As you all have probably heard, the Fallen of Albas structure deck finally has been released to the TCG, giving us Branded Fusion. Now, this is a big shakeup that was definitely needed in this format. I think that the format overall is in a pretty good spot right now. I do would like to have a ban list, which I actually have made a prediction on what it will be, so check that video out. It's going to be in over there, I think. Probably. But yeah, we're gonna take a quick look at the meta nowadays, because you all love your tier list videos. You know, what do you want to play, what do you not want to play. Let's just straight up jump into the list. I've shrinked the list down because normally I use the same template, but I was kind of done seeing like unplayable decks out there. So I think now that we have our overall pretty good estimate of what would be relevant for this format. Now we have tier 0, which will be just the absolutely most broken thing of all. And to start things off, it's just going to be the Brave Engine. Still, the Brave Engine still just so dominant. Definitely needs a hit somewhere in order for it to be less dominant. So everything that plays Brave is already automatically a little bit more ahead than the rest. Just because it's just so good. It's so much advantage you gain from that engine. So you will definitely see a trend for all the tier 1 decks that are presumably tier 1 will definitely be playing that. But yeah, there's not really a best deck of the format. There are like 3 decks I think that are just way ahead of the rest. And let's just jump right into it. At Ignister, definitely rogue right now. There's just too many hand traps for this deck to succeed. Everybody plays all the tools and this deck dies to all the tools. It dies to Ogre. It dies to Nip, which everyone is playing. It has a rough time against Imperm Vader as well. So it's a very bad place for you. Now, Alistair can actually run all those cards. But Alistair cannot run the Brave Engine. So inherently, I do not think that this is a deck that could be potentially tier 1. I think that Alistair definitely has a very good spot this meta, since everybody is overlooking Winda. But yeah, Alistair still gets Impermed. That's a better Ogre and the Biro matchup. So that is kind of nice, but it's just not enough power right now. Definitely the semi-limit to Nadir Servant definitely took a little bit of that consistency power away, and we are just about to notice that. Drytron, I would say, is a little bit better, but it just cannot run the hand traps right now. Drytron is just in a super messy, weird spot right now, where it cannot really have that good of an end board, because there's nothing really the deck naturally works towards against anymore. It cannot run the hand traps, and it dies to all the hand traps. So it's a pretty rough spot right now. I would say it's definitely better than Rogue. But it's really depending on the pilot. But we have been seeing a lot of success on this on regional level, etc. So that's kind of nice. B-Trooper, I just wish that the deck has a little bit more support. Get in the end, just not enough power right now, not enough advantage you can make. Branded is definitely gonna go to the tier 1. There are 2 versions you can play. You can play the Brave version, which is seeing a lot of success, but I do think that the pure version should not be overlooked. I personally, from what I've looked at, I really really like the pure version, but it takes a lot of skill. This is a very difficult deck to pick up. It's very nice that it was a structure deck, but it really sucks because a lot of players were going to have to learn how to play this deck. I still haven't figured that out myself. There is more branded stuff coming in the future. Stay tuned for that, guys. There are profiles coming. There's going to be combo guides coming soon. But I really have to get my hands on the cards. And right now that has been a little bit difficult for me. But this deck is definitely tier 1. Brankets is better. Brankets is arguably one of the best decks right now. Just its straight up interaction with Fate and a Brankit is just insane. There is one very big downside, which is why I do not think that it is the overall best pick. It's that going second, it really, really, really is a bad deck. There's not a lot of extending you can go to, not a lot of improving the field you can go to. And if you get disrupted in the right moments, going second, it definitely just sucks a lot. So it's really, really, really good. But going second, it's really, really not that great. Shadows, kind of the same as Alistair. I would never play Pure Shadows. Pure Shadows would be around here, I think. But the Winda engine is definitely good to system. But Pure Shadows is just not going to be able to compete. Flowander also dies to a lot of the hand traps. Ogre is good on the field spell. Vader Imperm are naturally good, just like Ash. And if your opponent has sided for it, then the Droll Knockbird is really, really good. And now that we've been seeing a little bit more popularity in Droll or in Droplet again, this deck is going to have a really, really tough time to compete in the meta. So definitely not one of the best decks. I think it's solid. We've definitely seen it a lot at the YCS, for example, and it got a lot of success. But this is definitely not one of the best decks of the format right now. Evil Twin is one of those decks that can run all of the hand traps. Literally, this deck can run all the good cards, but it's just hampered by a suboptimal engine. It's really good, don't get me wrong. But utility-wise, I don't think it would be better than Rogue. I think that a solid player can definitely put it to tier 2, but I think it's definitely the best of the Rogue deck. DDD. Still do not underestimate this deck, but this deck still isn't good. I've talked about this a lot on my last prediction. Thinking that this deck is really, really good is just cope. But we have the Zero King, the DDD Zero King, the USA promo is coming to Europe right now. So we may finally see some good players picking this deck up and maybe having some success with it. So yeah, definitely think that this deck is definitely up in the tier 2, definitely better than the two that we see here, because it can run the hand traps and can still combo afterwards. But if you know that you can just Ash or just Veiler to Gilgamesh, you always win. Guru is just Rogue right now, very bad place for the deck. It can run the hand traps, but it can't capitalize on the fact that it cannot run Brave, which sucks. And you also cannot really kill your opponent after hand trapping it 3 times. So this deck is definitely not in a good spot right now. It needs more cards to be playing with. Salads, still easy OTK, but also definitely suffers from the hand traps. Striker has been doing a little bit better. I've been seeing some lists. The POW lists are definitely cool. This deck is, I thought it was kind of dead. I thought it kind of fell off, but it returned a little bit. So that's very interesting to see. This deck can definitely still work. So don't underestimate the Sky Striker decks. I would say Virtual World still like all the way up here, but it also kind of has struggles. This deck is so good, this meta, but it's just nobody is playing it. It's really suboptimal to play with the Brave engine. It's really suboptimal to play it with Souls. You can play it pure, but then the deck just loses to itself. You can run hand traps, but not all of the hand traps. It's such a difficult deck. But the cool thing about this is that it can run Beatrice to get Sunmi rolled out, for example, or Token Collector, which is just very, very nice. So I would say that this deck is very solid, but it's just nobody's paying attention to this. But why would you pay attention to a deck like this if all the tier 1 decks are so widely available? So Virtual World's just very difficult to give it a place right now. But I definitely think that it's still good. Sword Soul, I would say right now, this deck's really good. This could definitely be the best deck of the format. But it's definitely in the top 3. The tier 1 decks are just very mixed in between. The order that they are in is very situational. I think that all the decks in tier 1 can definitely win OICS, for example. I'm just going to add the next one to it too. That's Rose Dragons. I think that these four are definitely just the best decks of the format. The Rose Synchro POW is just insane. Double Hulk of Firebreaks, Baron of Fleur. Maybe even running some Tengis, you don't have to run those, but you can. It's been proving to get a lot of success at the YCS. I know that Jesse Cotton was playing it, and definitely one of their lists got into the top cut as well. Prank, it's just insane. Again, just unfair interactions. Sword Soul, if you have a good Sword Soul player, it's going to be really difficult for you to win. And the branded deck is very new, very hype, very good. But we're going to have to wait and see how it definitely performs. And I think that all these decks are just very much increased by the player playing them. I think that we're in a very skill-intense meta, as weird as that might sound, because Brave might convince you otherwise. You really need to play these decks very well in order to consistently do good. Because you definitely see a lot of players just picking up these cards, just playing them, but then lacking on a technical skill to play it out. And they will definitely fall very much further down in the tournament. But you can see like the top decks are all very much skill intense, and everything that was not really that skill intense. Only Alistair is like down here. But yeah, definitely interesting meta to analyze it like that. This fell off. I think that it's like all the way over here. It's really weird to look at PK back and say this was like one of the best decks of the format. It should have been. But it's not really that great. Gonna tie that with the Tri-Brigade deck. Tri-Brigade's not in a good spot right now. It did get support from the Fusion deck, from the Alvis deck. Because there's a couple of Tri-Cards in there that you can run now. I think you can run a cool engine. But we're gonna have to wait and see how it performs. I think that Dragon Link is just very, very much the best tier 2 deck by far. Being popular, of course, for many years now. This deck just doesn't die, doesn't stop, and it shouldn't stop because this is a very healthy deck to play. You have to be really good to work, make Dragon Link work. And this or a Brave Dragon Link deck can all work very fine. And you have Plunder Patrol. So we're gonna put behind Flunder because Plunder kind of rhymes. But Plunder has been picking up in popularity insanely. Deck's been popularized by MBT and, of course, the captain himself, Bruce Wenzel. This deck is very, very good. It's in a very good spot, and we're gonna have reprints and ghosts from the past. So that's gonna be also very, very nice to see how this deck will perform if a lot more people have it in their hands. So we're gonna have to be excited to see what Plunder does, because I hope that this deck gets like support. Of course, we're all waiting for the new ship, but yeah, that's the meta, how I look at it. I think that you can play everything on screen right now, but it's definitely easier to see success with the tier one decks. Overall, I would say this is very solid. It's very solid, healthy meta. I'm very happy and content with the way it is right now. But if a couple of cancerous cards that I talk about in my banlist prediction, for example, get rid of the game, I think that we will all just enjoy this game a lot more right now. So yeah, that's my opinion. Let me know in the comment section down below if you agree or disagree. Check out the banlist prediction video. See you guys in the next one. Baguettes.